Greetings everyone, hello and welcome back to Frostpunk once more, day 150. Boy, this town is looking big at this point. We're closing in on 600 people. My goal right now is, of course, that we start a bit with automation and also using our steam cores here to its maximum. For that, first of all, a lost shipment. We've been asked to mediate a dispute between the hot springs and the children's mine. Our scouts found a shipment of food which was abandoned during a storm halfway between the two settlements. Both parties claim it. Give it to hot springs, give it to the children. The hot springs actually produce food and send it to us, so it doesn't really make sense that we would give it to them. Let's actually just give it to the children. And in this case, that totally makes sense, right? In that case. We have a beautiful town, haven't we? I mean, it's cold, of course, so you will not have a nice day at the beach. But at least at the gardens, there's actually people lining up for this. And of course, large gardens really make a difference there, keeping people happy. 5 steam cores, let's get cracking with what really matters. So we still have this major goal, major problem right now that we get, first of all, 30 amputees. These guys are just sitting around all day. Some of them are actually helping out in the cookhouse, right, with the improvement that we had, and the others are just sitting around. So this is not good. And second of all, we still work on a lot of extended shifts, especially all my gathering posts and coal thumpers here. And this is unfortunately with all of the steam hubs still required, right? It's too close there at the moment that any kind of emergency would actually also tip me over the point again. So what we're doing is now we are starting, yes, we are starting with finally the factory. This is a pretty big building, a plant where automatons and other highly advanced devices can be produced. And of course, other devices we are we're actually looking at Prothesis with that. Now, one thing we would like to do, also another industrial hothouse, the last one that we are squeezing in over here. And can I now get my factory in there? Ah, it would have been nice to have it here. No, it would not have. It would not really fit in. We can have it out here or in my industrial zone. Actually, this makes more sense, right? We already have a nice steam hub here. And out here, let's have the factory. It's not a really beautiful building. It's just a very loud building and dirty that is as well. So there it is, factory building on its way in an area where we don't need to have any gathering posts anymore then. And this actually drops us now to 2 steam cores, right? The next food production, and then also here now my factory. The goal is, to have more and more automation now then. But of course, this is still going to take a while. First and foremost, amputees. That is my goal. Now, there it is. And in this case here, let's assign some children to that again. Do we have extended shifts in the hothouses? We do. Let's keep the extended shift for now. Even though food-wise, we should be fine of actually turning it down here. Have a look what the difference is if I get the hothouses all to normal shifts, right? I mean, it's quite a big difference there, and it's still totally fine, right? We definitely did lose some food there, but we're still way ahead of what we actually consume. And at the end of the day, we have the factory running. There's no hazard so far, I'm wondering. And yeah, here we can now assign engineers to that, of course, and we can then decide what we want to produce. Let's start with the prosthesis, and yeah, they need 5 steel each. And we do need around 29 of them right now. So we're just going to produce 30 just to have something here for the future as well, right? And this will be quite a nice production. And with that, all of these amputees will finally get back to work or at least have a decent life running around. And there we have it, generator congestion, very next day. And once again, the generator consumes twice as much coal. And this leads to a total coal consumption of 777. And with that, we're even yet once again clear. Now, the factory should be starting now. A new workday starts in the name of there it is. And with that, we're now producing, then look at the speed of it. And this is now then directly reducing the amount of amputees. Or is it? Or actually, they will then just still be amputees, of course, but back to the workforce again. Something like that. We'll just see. Yes, now it's going down, actually. 27, 26, 25. Very good. Another big advancement there for Winterbourne. Emergency for the children. Of course, we can do this. An emergency aid. 250 wood is something we can easily afford at this point. I'm still on the lookout, of course, for more survivors as well. And the snow dune. Over there usually something juicy, right? But it's just very far away from any from everything. So definitely take some time. Oh yeah, and the children of mine are happy with that. In between, we get a two waves actually of survivors coming in. So from 600, we should have a nice bump to I think 650 or something. Very good. First is in, also steam cores. And the second one also has steam cores and survivors. So this was a jackpot this time around. Two survivor waves and two times steam cores. Just really on time once again for everything to close in. It's always a bit risky, always a bit that tingling sensation to get those guys there in. And there it is. And with that, we have actually 661. We definitely want to reach those 700. That's going to be the achievement. And in this case, let's suspend those scouts again. Yeah, performance is ticking a bit now. And I think we still have room for ample more. And let's just see. There it is once more. We got 16 cores. Now, the thing is, we don't need anything else anymore for the wood, right? The wood is now pretty much self-sufficient and we are endlessly producing that. And the ratio for that is super high. So we're talking about the steam sawmill produces 90 wood per day and the advanced wall drill produces 240 per day, right? So almost three times as much. And one of them is totally fine and already puts us over the edge. The same goes with the steel. Two is fine. We're capped on that anyway. So let's actually turn it off now for the storm then again. Also the wall drill, nothing that we need. The really big problem that we have is the coal still. And for that, we need to now build also the next advanced coal mine then in this slot here. So this is literally now the last slot that we have for this. You only get three. You only get three deposits, right? And this is now the next one. And yeah, let's have it then here. The problem with this one will actually be, if I want to automate that, we need to have a steam hub close by because the automatons need steam hubs to refuel. There's nothing here, right? So this is my resource area, a resource depot area. And that's not super ideal, but of course we'll manage. With that, we've used all the deposits then as well. And we still have three steam cores left. One of them I would like to use for another infirmary that we can squeeze in here into this spot, right? So this should really be done enough. I mean, with those people coming in, of course, the demand for that will be higher than ever before. This is definitely true. We have already the shrine here. It's affecting it. Perfect. Not that much we need to do there other than just build it and yeah, assign people to that. Level 4 it is. Next storm is coming in. Let's assign some 5 people to that infirmary. And then we still have two steam cores that we can use either for hothouses, something that I don't think we'll need for a while. So I rather probably, yeah, we're rather probably going to build automatons now finally, starting the automation. But let's get through that storm first. A new hazard, every new construction will require more steel. Question is, does it affect the automatons as well? No. They still have the same amount of steel that we always have. Yeah, I think that's it. Two steam cores. Let's go ahead and construct the first two automatons. Shall we do this? Interesting. Exciting. A new era starts with that. We just need a lot more steam cores now. And it's really quickly built. And there we get the first one. And we're of course going to now assign them to the coal mining. So here. We can now assign an automaton. It's going to produce less per hour, but it's going to work 24 hours. And there the bugger is coming out. A beast. Looking around real quick. We'll see what we can do. And on its way now. I mean, they're super scary, of course. Like there's a laser coming out and vaporizing people. Could happen anytime. And Tom Cruise is jumping into themselves distress. Other than that, they're going to work nicely for us now. The second one should be coming out then soon as well. And as we can see, yeah, the difference is quite there, right? So it's 20 coal per hour less, but 24 hours. That's the thing, right? There's also the steam hub here really close to it, so you can always refuel. All right, that's that. Rock Spire Supply Depot. We're continuing there. And there's the second one. And we're also going to assign this right away to the advanced coal mine. Also, those mines will not need any heaters anymore. So that is also some coal that we save out of this, right? Just by the way, activate that steam again. And there it's coming over. I mean, really impressive stuff, those guys. and it's now going to automatically then work and produce it. And with that, yeah, hopefully the long hours of toil we can reduce them soon now. Right, that's it. Let's just have a look at that. Frozen river, nothing over there. And icefall mine looks promising. Sounds promising at least. Where's my coal production looking at? With that, we are now at 9,000 coal production per day. So we can actually now raise it to steam level 4. And we're still 2,000 in advance. So next up is actually reducing now the workforce or the extended shifts for my gathering post and just see where we go with that. Let's start with a few. There you go. We also have that steelworks here still doing the extended shifts, and there's still a whole lot of them here. So it's reducing it by 4 hours per day, right? Which is, yeah, which is quite significant. And with that, we're closing it in. So below 2,000 now. It's all about that self-sufficiency here and that people can actually live in peace. And this has been bugging me for quite some time now, right? So we can further reduce it. This is already a normal shift. The hunters don't have shifts per se. I mean, not an extended shift that I can actually toggle. The steel the coal thumpers themselves. Yeah, this is pushing it now. But thanks to my automatons, we're having a 24-hour production now of coal. The cool thing is also the shrine still works, right? So we're still getting that 8% out of the... Oh, actually, it doesn't. This is the coal mining rationalization, the boost that the coal mines get. The shrine is not working anymore. Oh, I didn't know. All right. We have the food already turned off for the hot houses. So with that, we have a positive surplus still. Serious accident? Sir, there's been an accident. An automaton has stepped on a man, crushing his leg and crippling him for life. People argue that the automatons should walk more slowly and carefully, even at the cost of their own efficiency. Slow them down? No, we cannot. Actually, discontent will rise slightly. That's okay, actually, for me. I mean, just be careful, for God's sake. I mean, he's working in the coal mine. It's not like you're getting confused over there. So just do this. By the way, also, we have zero discontent now. And that is because we have no more overtime. We got the pleasure house. We got the fighting arenas. And yeah, actually, we don't have all houses in a fighting arena, right? So we have those guys here, for example, do not have a fighting arena. Let's build us two more here. Anything else? Yeah, there would be a fighting arena needed. Make sure that everybody has a fighting arena close by, really. And also no more extended shifts, right? And even with that, no more extended shifts. Very comfortable on the coal level, even on steam level 4. That means we don't ever need to go down in the temperature anymore. We can always stay now at the highest temperature for all of my zones, for all of my buildings, for all of my workers, right? Also on the food-wise, no more extended shifts, and we still have a very comfortable bonus there right now. We never ever need to worry about food anymore. People don't need to work longer. They don't need to work in the crappy things. The automatons are going to make sure of this. And yeah, quite honestly, this is the end of Frostpunk Extreme Megacity. We have achieved everything we wanted, right? The settlements are fully developed. We have a super big city. The only thing that I would really like to push now is the 700 people. And that's just really for the symbolic gesture. So let's just see if we can do this. Unfortunately, so far, I'm super unlucky with that. Yeah, those scouts will probably die. A bit too late there, right? The storm is going to hit again. And there's not a single wave of survivors, unfortunately, coming in this time. It's a bit unlucky. Okay, the storm is over. We actually got 3 steam cores back home. With that, I would like to produce, continue with 3 more automatons. Actually quite a lot, right? That we can then use right away on my next coal mine. And also probably on the wall drill, that otherwise is a workplace that's actually pretty cold. Children's mine. My people have a right to their own opinions. Please tell your people to watch the word. Some of them got into a shouting match with a foreman over his treatment of the children. I'll talk to them. Don't talk badly about the children, please. New automaton coming out. So this one here is now for the coal mine. And let's just have a look at the productivity of it now. And it's at 72 9, is it the same? Yeah, it's the same. So it doesn't calculate in the route it takes for it to get to the steam hub. And the next steam hub for this one is actually here, right? And I will not build another steam hub just for this one, because honestly it would be a pretty big waste of coal, right? That I don't want to afford with all of that. We're still very comfortable now, despite having everything running at maximum. So I'm really happy about this. The next automaton comes out. This one is probably then... I mean, it's faceted steel and wood is pretty much done. We could have it work at a steel, a steam coal thumper, right? So instead of my engineers having to dig up the coal, the automaton can do it now day and night, which is once again also pretty cool. Right, this content stays at zero now, so there's nothing else anymore. 600 are living near a fighting arena. That's just how it goes. And I'm still having this impossible task of actually finding survivors out there. After all these storms, there's barely any group out there anymore. Animal migration! Hunters bring in 90% less raw food. Well, that's not a big deal. My hunters are working just as placebo, really, so that those who want to hunt can actually go on a hunt, right? So it's just to keep people busy a bit. Even with that, we have no problem, thanks to the hothouses there as well. And if my hothouses are being a factor, we just relocate the other hunter huts that we have prepared for all of this. No problem over there. Ice draws goes to Snowy Hill. Unfortunately, this is all looking very unpromising again. So what I've just learned is that on endurance mode you cannot get to 700 people. Actually 600 is the cap and everything beyond that is just out of survivors, so we have it done. I was already wondering why there's no survivors anymore out there for three consecutive waves now, and there is none, right? So I can't find any more people. So we have officially finished this game, Winterbourne, as Prevailed, right? It is automated. It can basically function on its own now. I don't need to micromanage anything anymore. We have no more extended shifts. We have fully automated coal and food production also coming in, so I don't need to worry about that anymore. Most of my people are actually without a job at this point, so there is no point really in continuing. I hope you enjoyed this one. This is really the biggest Frostpunk base I've built so far. It is truly massive. And it also brings the engine a bit to its knees there when it comes to my frame rate. Overall, a super enjoyable game. The first, as always, the first three storms are super intense, and then it's all about expanding that base all the way up to the top, plus a bit of automation. We could continue with building automatons now, but other than that, that's the end of it. I hope you enjoyed this one, Frostpunk. We might have a look at the other scenarios there as well, up to Frostpunk 2. If you enjoy my content, please consider supporting me on Patreon and follow me live on Twitch as well. Other than that, see you in the comments and in the next Let's Play, Winterbourne Prevailed. Cheers!